We'll give glory to God. It's a new year. It's the fourth Sunday in the year 2021. We'll bless God for being able to keep us alive. We'll glorify Him because He has been faithful. And above every other thing, He has been wonderful. Irrespective of what 2020 brought to us, we give glory to God that we are steadfast enough not to fall away from His presence. And for that alone, we give Him honor, we give Him praise, we give Him adoration. May the name of God be exalted in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
It's a new year. Jokingly, a lot of people will say, I have a new year resolution. Some people will say, I have a paper plan for 2021. Some people will say, I have X, I have Y, I have Z. But listen, my dear friends, my brothers, my sisters, fathers, parents, listen to this. Anything you do without partnering God will not give you the desired result you require to get from Him. I pray for you this morning that in the year 2021, the power and the ability to partner with God will grant unto you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Before we go ahead, let us pray. Jehovah, Jesus Christ, Michael Mimo, Olorun Ayeraye, Ogo ni foruko re.
Hallelujah.
Aki okuse. Aki opose. Nitori anu re. Nitori ori ofe re. Nitori agbara re. Nitori iranlowo re. Loruko Jesu Oluwa gbope wa. Emi bi mo gba yin wa. Alaye nikan lo le niyo. Eni to ti ku ko ni reti kankan mo. Adupe gbo ka wa ma won alaye lati niyo. In je tori pipe abi yiye. Kì í ṣe nítorí pé a máa dúà gbà máa mórí kiri Ọlọ́run ṣùgbọ́n nítorí àánú rẹ wà títí orí ọ̀fẹ́ rẹ sì pọ̀ lórí wa a mọ lóore a sì mú ọkàn pẹ́ wá síwájú rẹ lónìí lórúkọ Jésù Olúwa gbọ́ pẹ́ wa lórúkọ Jésù Olúwa gbà yín wa lórúkọ Jésù Olúwa gbọ́ pẹ́ wa lórúkọ Jésù Olúwa gbà yín wa bá a ti ń wọnú ọdún tuntun lọ èyí ni ọjọ́ kẹta. Ojo ologo akoko ninu osu akoko ninu odun 2021 emi mimo oya wa ba wa rin alagbara wa ba wa rin olorun awon olorun wa ba wa rin oju ko ma ti wa oda ko ma yo wa aye ko ma bere olorun wa ni 2021 ma ja ba won kuku ojiji ai so buruko ma jo gbe wa de gbogbo erongbe wa ni rere lodun oluwa mu ise fun wa ran wa lowo ko ti wa leyin ba wa doju tota imo eni bi ma je ko se ti wa mu dopin odun je ki ayo igbala ko je ipe wa ori ofe re ma je ko fi wa sile nigba to ba doju ale je ka ri oga to ri ku je ki mole ko tan yi wa ka o se oni ma je mu aye Jesus Christ oluwa wa hallelujah
hallelujah
hallelujah. It's a new year. We give glory, we give honor, we give adoration to God. And so today, we are tagging the theme of our online service today, Ministration Sunday School Bible Class, as a new beginning. I think we need to define new beginning, or we define what is new. And the Holy Spirit laid it in my heart, gave me a little bit of word exposition about the book of Genesis chapter 1. I came to a new understanding of what Genesis chapter 1 was really talking about. And the Holy Spirit gave me a word exposition on the fact that the planet that was created without nothing in it, and God was silent for a period of time. The period of time the Bible did not talk about. And that was why if you read the book of Genesis chapter 1, verse 1, it says, in the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. Full stop. He did not digress into 2, to verse 2. He did not digress to verse 3. He stopped at verse 1. In the beginning, He created heaven and earth. When he created it for his majestic, for his own majestic purpose. He created it in the aura of his own favor because he's God. At the time God created it, God had no plan on what to do with planet earth. You may not get it, but you get it in a while. Nigba ti Olorun da aye ati orun Olorun o lero ngba nto ma fi se Olorun koko da o fi ile nbe oni Genesis chapter 1 verse 1 so fun wa ko fi nkoko sinu e nkoko o si nbe o kon da o wa nbe. And the Bible did not stipulate to us the period of time God waited before he came to verse 2. And verse 2 now gave us an explanation of what God created and what it looked like. And what did it look like? What it looked like was in verse 2. In verse 2 he said, and the earth was without form and void. And darkness was up upon the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters. O tumo si pe ni verse 2, o ṣalaye fun wa bi in t'Olorun da se ri nigba yen. It was void, it was empty, there was darkness. The only thing to wa nbe ni pe emi Olorun o ra baba loju omi. Olorun o se nkankan sibe. My topic is a new beginning. It only means you pe o le ti wa laye ko ma ni pinu otun ko de ti pe 30 ko ti pe 40 ko ti pe 50 ko Olorun ma ti bere nkan tuntun ninu aye. And that's the new beginning I'm talking about today. My new beginning is not about because you have not been in existence. My new beginning has to do with the fact that God is about to outline certain things that is different from what it was when he created you. God created the heaven and the earth. Nothing was in it. It was void. There was darkness. Nothing was happening there. No activities. And the Spirit of God was only hovering upon the depth of the sea. God did nothing. And after a period of time, God spoke. Listen to this. In the book of Genesis chapter 1 verse 3, the Bible now said, and God said, after he had created it, after he has done everything, after his spirit was hovering, over time, near me, Olorun fi wa lori omi, Olorun wa ni ipinu wi pe, okay. E je ki imole ko wa. Do you know this distance of space and time between the time tell me Olorun fi ra baba loju omi and the time ti Olorun wa pase pe ki mole wa? The Bible did not tell us that, but God gave me a word exposition this morning about what we are saying right now. We pe ki se pe lojo kan na ki se losu kan na ki se lodun kan na Olorun do run wa aye ki se losu kan na emi re ra baba loju omi fun awon akoko kan leyin na Olorun wa woye pe kini to ti e wa nle ti o si nkan kan to nse e je ki wa sise le lori. I pray for you today. Ile aye re ti ko ni tumo. Irin ajo re ti ko lere. Ni 2021, loruko Jesu, ninu aye re Olorun a sise agbara. Ninu aye re Olorun a sise iyan. Holy Ghost will bless you.
Amen.
Holy Ghost will bless you.
Amen.
Holy Ghost will bless you.
Amen.
For this revelation will bring a testimony.
Amen.
For this word will bring a revelation.
Amen.
And by the revelation there shall be a testimony.
But
boy, what you are here, that word you come, we decree the light of God into your life. That in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, Lord God, yes, oh yeah, imole ko wonu aye. Imole ko wonu irin ajo. Hello, somebody.
Hello,
sir. Ki se pe Olorun kan lo da e. Ki se pe majebu o si fu e. But you are void, you are empty, and there is darkness in your situation. Ki se pe Olorun kan lo seda e. Ki se pe Olorun kan lalakoso re. He created man in his own image. Gbogbo eyan to da aworan Olorun ni. But what I'm saying this morning ni pe Olorun se da e. There is no God activity in your life. This revelation will bring a testimony. Ko si activity Olorun kankan ninu aye re, lagbo ara re, lori ise re, ninu irin ajo re. The activity of God is not visible. The only activity of God that is in your life is the breath you breathe. How about his wondrous work? In verse 3, he said, let there be light. And there was light. He separated light from darkness. God activity. Is that activity in your life? Is darkness still not reigning in your life? Is the power that be heavenly as terrestrial powers, are they not operating under who you are, within who you are, in who you are? It only means God is dormant, God is docile in your life. His activities are not being manifest. Bi emi Olorun se ku lori omi nigba to dorun ataye ti emi re ko shonkom emi re ko sise kokan emi re ko run ise kokan jade o duro sibe. It was dormant, it was visible, but God was not active. And over a period of time, God decided to be active, and God said, now it's time for me to be active. And God said, let there be light. And there was light. And you know what the Bible said? And the Bible said, and God saw it was beautiful. Olorun si ri pe o dara. Am I talking to somebody
yes,
here?
Yes.
You may know Jesus. You may be a born-again Christian. Is God activity visible in your life? Then if it is not visible, it is time for you to call the light of God into your life so that a new beginning can take place. So that the failures of the past, the rejection of the past, the disappointment of the past, the sickness of the past, the illness of the past, the poverty of the past, they can become history when God activity begins to be activated in your being. Mo gbadura fun ni oruko Jesu eni ta komogi lati aro ilo ise ati ise Olorun ninu aye re lodun tutun yi loruko Jesu yo bere ise loruko Jesu yo bere ise loruko Jesu yo bere ise loruko Jesu yo bere ise. Some people ask Olorun ko lo da mi ni ki Olorun wo ese taye mi fi wa ri bayi ese ti ise mi fi wa ri bayi ese tona mi fi ri bayi ese tai so fi fe pa mi Olorun ko lo da mi ni iru ki le le yo Olorun. You will begin to question God instead of you to ignite the light of God into your life. Some people will ask me, how will I ignite the activities and the light of God in my life? The question now is, God was dormant over a period of time. And after some time, God ignited himself and said, let there be light. And there was light. And the Bible said, he separated light from darkness. Lani wati go bagbara. Iran tabi tidile tabi tokuku to njoba ninu aye re ninu odun tutun ojo logo akoko yi. The activity of God is activated, and today loruko Jesu laarin wa tagbara be emi mimo oye opin ni ya
amen
alagbara opin ni ya
amen
oba won ba opin ni ya
amen
hallelujah
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 hallelujah.
You must be ready for Jesus. You must be able by prayer to ignite the light of God in you. By godly activities, you must be able to ignite the power of God in you. Olorun wa sinu ogbo ojojumo lo ri Adam. Njo ko wa ko ri Adam nitori imole Adam ku. To pe Olorun ba ti wole, e ma gbagbe o. Adam oriran o eyin oriran gba tolorun da won ki se pe won oriran lati Jesu. Their spiritual eyes were not opened. So ti Olorun ba ti wole nitori pe they were sinless, won ri itoso re ko wole. Sugbon nijo ti oju ebi won si ni won woye pe won wa ninu ese ni won woye pe o ye ka mo sara pamo ni won loye wi pe awon wa ni oho. It was their spiritual eyes that were opened, not their physical eyes. Their physical eyes saw they were naked, but they didn't believe there was anything wrong in it, because that was how God created them. Gbogbo agbara to pa imole Olorun ninu aye. Gbogbo ese to pa imole Olorun ninu aye. I decree the forgiveness of God from the cross of Calvary, and because it's a new year and a new beginning, today the heavens will forgive you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
a gbọdọ mọ eni ta gbagbọ a gbọdọ mọ nta duro le a gbọdọ mọ ri majemu to da wa si mo gbadura fun elekan si loruko jesu imole yo tan fun e 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 I decree imole yo tan fun e because it's a new beginning. God will raise up the light of his countenance upon you, and wherever the devil has put you or shielded you away from his glory, today the light of God will locate you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
It was beautiful in the sight of God. It was wonderful in the presence of God. And God said, Emi atu se mi si. Bibeli wa je ko ye mi. To ba wo verse 4. And God said the light, and God saw the light, and it was good. And God divided the light from the darkness. And in verse 5, God said, he called the light day, and the darkness he called night. And the evening and the morning was the first day. And that was when God's activity started. Over a planet that he created, when he created it, there was no activity in it. When he created it, God was docile and dominant, was dormant, nothing was happening. Nothing was happening. God was just there. The only activity we were meant to understand was the Spirit of God was hovering over the depth of the sea, but it was not active. And Emi le wa ninu aye, and it may not be active. Imole Olorun gaga imole ni. Sugbon ninu Genesis, won ni okukun wa loju ibu. Emi Olorun sin ra baba loju ibu. And at a point in time, God did not deem it fit to say, let there be light. God may live in you, and the light of God is not in you. Some scholars may question me, but I'm not going to argue about that. But I know what I'm saying by this spiritual exposition. God may be in you, and the light of God is not in you. Ina le wa ni gbogbo nu church yi ta ba re ni to ma ba wa tan ina yin o ni wulo. If God is in you and it is not activated in you, then the Spirit of God in you becomes useless. Because it has no activity. It has nothing working. I pray for you. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. In this new year, every dormant situation in your life, the activity of God will begin in you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And you know what he said in verse 6? And in verse 6, and God said, let there be firmament in the midst of the waters, and let it divide the waters from waters. As yao mi ko laro mi wa wa ri omi okun wa ri omi osa won wa legbe ara won won o de ni kan ra won won ma se bayi. Unbelievable. Won ma se bayi, won ma se bayi bi gbe ki won kora won o de ni kora won ma se bayi bi gbe kon sumora won o de ni sumora. And the most wonderful thing about it is this. The most wonderful thing about it, nibe, wari kolo mi okumbai, ayato. Wari kolo mi osa, ayato. Wande sumora mo, wande ni koja lori ara mo. He divided waters from waters when the activities of God took place. I pray for you this morning that in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, if the power of God has been in your life and it is dormant, I ignite the light of God in your life for a beautiful activity in the year 2021 in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You know, some people ask a physical question. If the light of God is in me, why am I sick? If the light of God is in me, why is the devil attack coming into my body? If the light of God is in me, why is the enemy using poverty to challenge me in the presence of my God? If the light of God is in me, why is mysteries and so many things, calamities, befalling me? If the light of God is in me, and I tell you this morning, the light of God that is in you is not active. And I challenge you to prove me wrong. But like I said, it's a new beginning. And we pray that in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, the power of the Holy Ghost that will activate the light of God in you, it will come upon you today in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Spiritual activities from the heavens of heavens that will connect with your physical body to ignite the light of God for his purpose upon your life, they will be activated today in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Is your year of new beginning?
Amen.
And God is starting something new.
Amen.
And I pray for you, because that light will be ignited. Amen. There will be no power or force that will be able to stop the activities of God in your life this year, in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah, somebody.
Hallelujah,
hallelujah, somebody.
Hallelujah,
hallelujah, somebody.
Hallelujah.
This morning, by this word exposition, I pray for you that in the name of Jesus, in the year 2021, you will break down barriers.
Amen.
In the year 2021, miracles will abound for you.
Amen.
In the year 2021, you will be called a new name. In the year 2021, God's light and activity will be ignited in your life in the name of Jesus. Owo Olorun yo wa lara re. Iyanu la yo se. Ori e oni gbagbo. Elede oni katua. Imole Olorun ninu aye re yo dide. Agbara idile koni daduro. Agbara aye koni daduro. Agbara ota koni daduro. The spiritual activities of God that will ignite the light for prosperity, for salvation, for healing, for deliverance, they shall come upon you this year in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The book of Revelation chapter 12 says, and their word were their testimonies. And I pray for you this morning, by this word of God, in your life, there will be testimonies.
Amen.
On your job, there will be testimonies.
Amen.
In your body, there will be testimonies.
Amen.
Psalm 107 verse 20, he sent forth his word, he healed them from their diseases and taketh away their souls. I pray by the word of God today and by this word exposition this morning, God will visit you.
Amen.
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 And there will be testimonies. Bobby Moses of my grace, your year of new beginning. And I pray for you, nothing will be able to stop you.
Amen.
No power or force that will be able to stop you.
Amen.
Ephesians chapter 6. From verse 10, he says, put on the whole armor of God. Egbe gbogbo armor Ọlọrun. Keyin ko le koju si arekereke isu. Nitori eje ti ara kole yin baja. Awon alase bi okoko aye yi ati awon emi buburu loju orun. There are terrestrial powers that rule in the affairs of men. Isaiah 47 was clear about it. And don't forget the magis. The magis, the Bible did not call them prophets. The Bible called them magis. Do you know the meaning of magis? The wise ones. Why do they call them the wise ones? They call them the wise ones because they were able to read the stars. They could interpret the moon. They could interpret the sun. When a new star appears, they could know the language of that star. And when the star of Jesus appeared, it was like a normal star to every other person. But the magis were able to read it. They read it and said, this is a sign of a child that is born of God. And the Bible said, they followed the star until they got to Bethlehem. And when they got there, they followed the star into the manger. And you know what science is able to do about that today? That is why science, if you are in Sokoto and you committed a crime in Ibadan, they will use their tracking to track you to Sokoto. That is the star tracking of the magis. It shall be well with us.
Amen.
It shall be well with us.
Amen.
It shall be well with us.
Amen.
I repeat again, it shall be well with us.
Amen.
Listen, the new beginning I'm telling you about is not about resolution. The new beginning I'm telling you about is not your paper plan for 2021. The new beginning I'm telling you about is not about you made a resolution that this is the way I want to do 2021. That's not the new beginning I'm talking about. The new beginning I'm talking about is God's activities to start afresh in your life so that every docile and dormant situation in your life will be activated to the glory of God. And listen to this, your year does not matter. You may be 15, you may be 40. You may be 50, you may be 70. It doesn't concern God. Because even at 90, Aunt Sarah had a visitation. Even at 82, Elizabeth had a visitation. You will be strong in your spirit.
Amen.
You will be strong in your body.
Amen.
You will be strong in your soul.
Amen.
The light of God will re-energize
Amen.
You. And testimonies will abound
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
So you need to claim it. When you claim it, you act on it. You act on it because 2021, this is a new beginning. It's not a new beginning because you're starting afresh. No, that's not what I'm talking about. It's not a new beginning because you are rewriting your paper plan. No, that's not what I'm talking about. I'm talking about God's spiritual activities taking place in your life to the testimony and to the glory of God. That's the new beginning we're talking about. In the name of Jesus, it shall be well with us.
Amen.
I love you along you, Bawagbe.
Yes.
Your fellow, you to fuwa.
Yes.
I love you along you, Bawagbe.
Yes.
Your fellow, you to fuwa.
Yes.
I love you along you, Bawagbe.
Yes.
Your fellow, you to fuwa.
Yes.
Don't forget, we'll keep on postponing because we know the devil is at war. But God is the ultimate winner. So tomorrow morning, 6 to 6:30 a.m., we're starting the YouTube program, Gaining Ground. We discovered fully that the devil is really at work. He doesn't want people to gain ground, but we will gain all lost ground in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
So join us tomorrow on YouTube. Prophet Deborah Levins on YouTube. Join us tomorrow. We shall be starting gaining ground, and there will be a move of God, and every lost ground will be returned back to you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Because God promised David. David said, should I pursue? The Lord said, pursue. Will I overtake? The Lord said, you will overtake. And he asked God, will I recover? God said, you will recover. And he said, I will pursue, I will overtake, and I will recover. So, in gaining grounds, from tomorrow morning, 6 to 6:30 in the morning, you will pursue, you will overtake, and you will recover. Every lost ground in the name of Jesus. Psalm 126 was explicit. Emio daikolosyo nipada. You shall become a testimony. You shall become a testimony. You shall become a testimony. In the mighty name of Jesus. So we pray for you as we begin to navigate 2021. With God on our side, we shall be winners. With God on our side, we shall overcome.
Amen.
With God on our side, we shall be triumphant.
Amen.
You need to stay safe. The new virus, the new variant, and the resurgence of the virus is real. You need to be careful. You need to be watchful. You need to observe all safety protocols. We pray that in the name of Jesus, we shall be divinely protected.
Amen.
The hand of God will rest upon us, and there shall be testimonies in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
God bless you. Do enjoy your Sunday and have a wonderful morning.